life hoodies for when the wind move. A lifestyle like no other, how you want it. When you jumping out your covers, then you cover what you into.
What's up, ladies and gents? Brian here with MachineMasters.com. I'm bringing you my first video in my video series that's going to go throughout the entire process that I took when I recorded Skyzoo's latest project, Music for My Friends. I was the lead mix engineer on that. Lucky enough for that. So what I really want to do is I want to teach you guys, give you guys tips on anything that pertains to rap vocals and R&B vocals and things like that, getting it to fit well in the mix of a beat and all that, whether you're working with a two-track of a beat or track outs. This first video is going to focus on the track Civilized Leisure. It's the 11th track in the album. It's a super, super cool record, one of my favorites on the album, so I figured I'd start off on a high note. I'll start off just playing you guys his first verse, and then I'll get into what I did. Here you guys go, take a listen.
Hey, life hoodies for when the wind move. A lifestyle like no other, how you want it. When you jumping out your covers, then you cover what you into. And pray to whoever you praise that you live through. Living for the light till the light become a signal. And signals to you as the one to empty a clip to. But then it turns round like the signals on a dial. And the lights hop up out of nowhere like they the symbols. Kill them and watch them get them moving like a heart rate. Looking for a dimmer, get the cooking all winter. And you looking more blizzard and this turns into a bar raid. Hide everybody strip and get your arms raised. Check day jump. Jumping, chest plate thumping, freestyle to it, don't a neck brace want it. Soundtrack to the shooter, the soundtrack to it, the background music, how the background do us for the civilized leisure.
This leisure needs to be civilized.
Alright, so there you have it. There's his first verse. Usually when I engineer a track, I would usually do it a little different. I wasn't the engineer for the track, I didn't record him. But the engineer that worked with him on this track, instead of punching in, he just made a complete separate track, which is fine too, but I usually would punch in and just do crossfading, so that's why you might be a little confused by this. These and these are all part of the same verse. So, without further ado, let's get into the mix process of this track and how I go about most of my, rap vocal mixings. So generally whenever I'm working on a vocal track, I like to start off with subtractive EQ, meaning you don't add things, you don't, like, for example, for this third band, increase at 369, 3695 K, whatever. You strictly subtract. You stay to bring in frequencies down. And then I bring out the compressor, I level all the volumes out, add a little gain, and then after that, I hit the additive EQ, meaning I'll add frequencies to try and hit a certain tone that I'm trying to reach and whatnot, and then that's when I'll send it off to whatever buses I'm going to set it off to. So to start off, the track, if you listen to it, the beat all the way through, it's a very low-end beat. There's not a lot of crazy high-end stuff going on, like synths and things like that. It's pretty much like a keyboard, and then it has like a couple sounds accompanying it, but relatively the frequency range is around 1K and below, probably even lower than that, which is why I tried to unmuddy a lot of it. Normally with vocal tracks, I would drop out this low end like I did. I'll do that usually mainly for every vocal track I'll ever mix, just because there's not a lot of frequencies you hear in this range with vocals. So, I mean, there's no point in having it there if the human ear can't hear it. It just muddies up tracks as far as harmonics and whatnot. So you want to cut out a lot of these frequencies. And for this track, for the second band, I cut out some of this low end because, well, more mids, because when I was listening to this, I'm going to end up playing this for you, but when I was listening to this frequency right here, it sounded super boxy to me, like kind of nasally and boxy. I'm going to play this for you right now so you could hear it. I'm going to solo the vocal track and I'm just going to increase this frequency and you'll hear what I'm talking about.
Hey, life hoodies for when the wind move. A lifestyle like no other, how you want it. When you jumping out your covers, then you cover what you into. And pray to whoever you praise that you live.
So you can see what I'm talking about. It's super boxy, and I didn't really like that sound, so I cut out that frequency. And a rule of thumb before I keep going, every recording track you're ever going to mix is going to be different. There's no formula. I mean, I'm sure a whole bunch of other videos talk about this kind of stuff on YouTube, and it's really just true. You just got to mess around with it, and whatever ends up sounding good, you want to keep. So just keep that in mind. Like, don't just go and copy these settings on every single record you ever record from this point on, just because it's what I did. It's just what I thought sounded good for this one particular record. So just keep that in mind. And then for this third part of the EQ, the third band, you know, a lot of times when you're messing with someone's vocals, you'll find these kind of sharp frequencies. I'm going to play it for you right now, so you know what I'm talking about. It's just a frequency you really just... It doesn't please my ears, so I usually cut these out. Here, take a listen.
A life hoodies for when the wind move. A lifestyle like no other, how you want it. When you jumping out your covers, then you cover what you went to and pray to who...
See, you can see what I'm talking about. It's kind of like a sharp tone. I like cutting those out. All right, so that's really it for the EQ. It was a good track. Whoever recorded it did a great job tracking this, and it's a great overall track to have as a raw, dried, no effects. So it makes my job easier. So shout out to whoever recorded this. Then next up, I added the compressor. This is the Renaissance compressor by Waves. I like this compressor because it's super transparent. Now, my take on rap vocals is they're supposed to be like kind of in your face. I mean, the lyrics are the main part of the entire record, so you want that to be heard. So I like to make everything predominantly the same level. Like, you're not going for a super crazy vocal range as far as dynamics compared to like maybe an R&B singer. So I like to level everything out. So you can see once I start playing the music that this threshold is pretty much at like the average. It's below the average like peak spot. So basically this compressor is on nonstop, and it has a super fast attack. So everything, when you're hitting these peaks right here, this compressor is taking care of that. And you can see that it's at a 4.06 ratio. So that's I don't want to say high, but it's a good compression rate. And then I just added 1.4 decibels of gain. So let me play this for you, and you could take a listen and see where the level's coming out as far as this threshold.
A life hoodies for when the wind move. A lifestyle like no other, how you want it. When you jumping out your covers, then you cover what you went to and pray to whoever you praise that you live.
So you can see that this compressor is always on, and it's getting rid of 6 to 12 dB most of the time, which is actually pretty high. Normally I might not even do that much. Normally I don't like to go above 6, but as far as this record went and like messing around with these settings and whatnot, I thought that ended up being a good sitting point for the vocal. And then lastly, I added this additive EQ at the end. Now for the additive EQ, I kept it super simple. All I did was just add some high end around 7K just to add more presence to his voice and push it to the forward more. Generally, a rule with EQ and just the physics of sound overall is the further away something is, the less high end frequency there will be. So say you have, picture yourself at like a nightclub or something. You're outside in line waiting for the nightclub. All you're hearing are these low end frequencies. You don't hear any of these high ends because they're cut out, because you're further away and they're getting muffled by the walls of the club, the reflections are bouncing off everything. So you're really only hitting these low ends. And you'll even notice that it's called the Doppler effect. Like when like a police car driving by, that frequency is going to, you're not going to hear as many of those high frequencies if the car is right next to you compared to if it's 2 miles away or whatnot. So if you want something to sound more in your face, more predominant in the track, what I like to do is I just like to do a little shelf on the high end, and I like to boost the high end frequencies a little bit. So here's everything besides the reverb on this lead vocal track with all the instrumental going simultaneously. Take a listen.
A-life hoodies for when the wind move. A lifestyle like no other, how you want it. When you jumping out your covers, then you cover what you into. And pray to whoever you praise that you...
So what I think the most noticeable thing is that compressor. You really notice the difference compared to the before. So I'm going to just bypass that compressor and show you guys. I'm going to hit bypass halfway through and you could really hear a difference. Take a listen.
A-life hoodies for when the wind move. A lifestyle like no other, how you want it. When you jumping out your covers, then you cover what you went to. And pray to whoever you praise that you...
You could tell that it really sets the vocal in a certain spot in the mix and it sounds a lot better. All right, so now that was the main processing for the dry vocal itself. After I was done with that, I sent that off to a bus, a reverb bus, and Sky didn't really like a lot of reverb on his vocal tracks. He likes kind of just the raw, gritty, like old school, just straight hip-hop kind of feel. So that's what we were really going for with this record. So I didn't really add a lot of reverb. All I did was really use it to take up these tiny little spaces in his verses where there was nothing there. Maybe glue these two tracks together, the overdub and the lead. Well, both technically the lead, but these two, just glue those all together and make it sit in the mix a tiny bit more, make it sound like it's in the same room as the rest of these instruments. So let me take a listen to that with this soloed out.
A-life hoodies for when the wind move. A lifestyle like no other, how you want it. When you jumping out your covers, then you cover what you into. And pray to whoever you praise that you live through. Living for the light till the light become a signal. And signals to you as the one to empty a clip to. Then it turns round like the signals on a...
So you can see the difference with that too. Now another little tip that I learned a while ago that I think really improved my mixing tenfold is... Any time-based effects, whether it's a reverb or a delay or anything like that, you want to use those as send effects. You don't want to put a reverb directly on this because then you're losing some of the original quality of the dry track compared to just completely sending that entire dry track to a bus, which I believe is over here. Over here. So this is this right here, AUX 1. That's the reverb bus. So basically, you send that entire dry signal over to this track by putting the input as the reverb, and you make this 100% wet. So on this track, you're not getting any of that dry sound. You're strictly getting the reverb of it. So it's not like you're duplicating the dry and making the overall track louder, lead vocal track louder. You're just sending that entire vocal track over here and making it so that way it's only the affected version of that track. So therefore, you keep the entire quality of this original lead, and then you get the effect that you're trying to reach. And then you could also see here that I EQ'd the reverb track. It was just maybe the S's and stuff that you get when you're recording on a microphone. The microphone might have been a little sibilant, so you might had a harsh S, or like the sh sounds like an sh, so that could be brought out a lot with reverbs. So I just cut off some of the high end. So that's really it for as far as his rap vocals went. There's a lot more that went into this record, like Mosaic, who's a singer. Her vocals are mixed, but we're gonna get into singing vocals around part two. So the next video we're gonna hit into that, and then we'll go from there. So if you guys have any questions, just let me know. I'm more than happy to help. And until next time, have fun mixing, guys.
A-life hoodies for when the wind move. A lifestyle like no other, how you want it. When you jumping out your covers, then you cover what you into. And pray to whoever you praise that you live through. Living for the light till the light become a signal. And signals to you as the one to empty a clip to. Then it turns round like the signals on a dial. And the lights hop up out of nowhere like they the symbols. Kill them and watch them get them moving like a heart rate. Looking for a dimmer, get the cooking all winter. And you looking more blizzard and this turns into a bar raid. Hide everybody, strip and get your arms raised. Check day jump. Chest plate thumping, freestyle to it. Don't a neck brace want it. Soundtrack to the shooter, the soundtrack to it. The background music, how the background do us for the civilized leisure.
This leisure needs to be civilized. Gotta have it, it's already mine. It's already ours. It's already.
stairs. The sinners in the air, the smell of rosé and a nickel-plated glare. The bezzy rotates while the middle make them stare. Heavy on the bass, let it